అందరికీ నమస్కారం. తమిళనాడు ఆరునర్ తిరు బనవలాల్ పురోహిత్జీ అవర్గలే, అమేచర్ డి జయకుమార్ అవర్గలే, తిరుమతి శ్రీమతి విఎల్ ఇంద్రాదత్ అవర్గలే, తిరు సి ప్రతాప్ రెడ్డి అవర్గలే, తిరుమతి వనితా దాట్ర అవర్గలే, తిరు డాక్టర్ వందే మాతరం శ్రీనివాస్ అవర్గలే, సహోదర సహోదరిగలే, అనివారికు వణకం. ఫ్రెండ్స్, ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు కాంప్లిమెంట్ ది ఆంధ్ర చేంబర్ ఆఫ్ కామర్స్ ఫర్ ద సక్సెస్ఫుల్ కంప్లీషన్ ఆఫ్ 90 ఇయర్స్. సక్సెస్ఫుల్ మీన్స్ మీనింగ్ఫుల్, కన్స్ట్రక్టివ్. Chamber of Commerce, which is one of the oldest institutions of the country in this historic city of Chennai. And I also would like to compliment the office bearers of all these times and years for contributing their might to the dynamic running of this organization. Thirdly, I would like to compliment శ్రీమతి ఇందిరా దత్ జీ ఫర్ హర్ లీడర్షిప్ ఇన్ టేకింగ్ దిస్ మూమెంట్ ఫార్వర్డ్ అండ్ మేకింగ్ ఇట్ ఎ డైనమిక్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఎక్స్పాండింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ది కంట్రీ. ఐ ఆల్సో వుడ్ లైక్ టు కాంప్లిమెంట్ శ్రీమతి వనితా దాట్రా, లేడీ ఇండస్ట్రియలిస్ట్, and also Dr. Vande Matram Srinivas, the famous music director, singer, who brought Telugu's name and fame, and Dr. C. Pratap Reddy, one of the pioneers of the medical health mission across the country, who also happens to be a Telugu man. And Sri Jayakumar Honorable Minister is here. I was telling in other meetings also, I want to repeat the same. When I said that Nellur chapter is going to be opened, I said Nellur is my district. Pratap Reddy was heard saying, "Sir, you belong to every district is your district." But after all, you were also born in some district, na? So one has to remember the district. And I always say, everyone should remember 4 things. Kanna Thalli, mother who has given you birth. Second, Janma Bhumi, the place where you are born. And third, mother tongue, the language which has come from mother's womb. And Matru Bhumi, the country to which you belong to. So Kanna Thalli ni, Janma Bhumi ni, Matru Bhashanu, Matru Desani, Marichipoyina Vadu, Manavude Kadu. This is my belief. And at the same time, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, we are Indians. Veshamu bhasha vereina manamanta bharatiyulam, alag bhasha alag vesh phir bhi apna ek desh, vividhata mein ekata bharat ka visheshata. That's the greatness of this India. You are here in Tamil Nadu, yes, you must observe the rules and regulations, the traditions and the culture of this place, because you are a resident here in Chennai. But at the same time, your mother tongue should never be forgotten. And I always tell all the children, new generation, old generation, please speak in your respective houses in your mother tongue. If Tamil is your mother tongue, speak in Tamil. If Telugu is your mother tongue, speak in Telugu. Make it a habit to the children also, because bhasha dani madhuryamu cheppa నలవి కానిది. భాష భావన ఈ రెండు కలిసి ముందుకు వెళ్తాయి. మాతృభాషలో మనము మరింత స్వేచ్ఛగా, మరింత సరళంగా, మరింత మధురంగా మనము మన భావనలను వ్యక్త చేయగలము. అలా కాకుండా ఇతర భాషల్లో కొంత ఇబ్బంది ఉంటుంది. మాతృభాషను మర్చిపోతే ఇంక వేరే భాష నేర్చుకున్నా దానికి అంతటి మాధుర్యం రాదు, అంతటి అందం రాదు. మాతృభాష ఎలాంటిదంటే కళ్ళ లాంటిది. మిగతా భాషలు ఎలాంటివి అంటే కళ్ళద్దాలు లాంటివి. కళ్ళుంటే కళ్ళద్దాలు పనిచేస్తాయి. కళ్ళేది ఏమనుకోండి, నువ్వు కళ్ళద్దాలు పెట్టుకున్నా అందం ఉంటుంది కానీ చూపు ఉండదు. అందుకని ఎవ్రీబడీ షుడ్ మాస్టర్ ద మదర్ టంగ్. బీడ్స్ తెలుగు, తమిళ్, కన్నడ, మలయాళం, మరాఠీ, అసామీ, పంజాబీ, భోజ్పురి, వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్, ఫస్ట్ మాస్టర్ యువర్ మదర్ టంగ్. మేక్ యువర్ చిల్డ్రన్ ఆల్సో టు స్పీక్ ఇన్ యువర్ మదర్ టంగ్. అండ్ ఆల్సో రిమెంబర్ యువర్ నేటివ్ ప్లేస్. ద సేమ్ టైమ్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ అన్ ఇండియన్. మనందరం భారతీయులు అనే విషయాన్ని మనం మర్చిపోకూడదు. ఆ దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకొని ముందుకు వెళ్ళాల్సిన అవసరం ఎంతో కూడా ఉంది. ఫ్రెండ్స్, టుడే యాజ్ ఐ వాస్ టెలింగ్, ఐ వాజ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ టు కమ్ హియర్ టు దిస్ ఫంక్షన్. అండ్ ఐ బికేమ్ మా వైస్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ ఐ వాజ్ నాట్ ష్యూర్ బికాజ్ ఐ యూస్ టు కమ్ టు ఆంధ్ర చేంబర్ ఆఫ్ కామర్స్ అండ్ దెన్ ఐ హ్యావ్ స్పెషల్ అఫెక్షన్ ఫర్ ఇందిరా దత్జీ బికాజ్ షీఈస్ డైనమిక్ అండ్ షీఈస్ ఇన్నోవేటివ్. షీ వర్క్స్ వెరీ హార్డ్ అండ్ షీ టేక్స్ పబ్లిక్ సర్వీస్ యాజ్ ఎ మిషన్, నాట్ ఫర్ కమిషన్ వితౌట్ ఎనీ రెమిషన్. సో ఐ హ్యావ్ దట్ అఫెక్షన్ అండ్ దర్ వోంట్ బి ఎనీ డిఫెక్షన్ ఇన్ దట్ అఫెక్షన్ ఫర్ ఎవర్. బట్ when I became vice president, our people started telling me, sir, you can't do this, you can't do this, you can't go here, you can't go here, you have to follow this, you have to follow that and all. There is a protocol. They said, you can't go by regular flight, you have to go by only Air India, you have to go by Indian Air Force. And 25 people will accompany you, 25, to take care of me. And who will take care of them, I don't know. And you have 4 doctors accompanying you, day in and day out, 24/7, at home, outside also. And then you attend functions of a particular this thing and all. Okay? Slowly I'm trying to understand and make them also to understand what is public life, how we have to conduct ourselves. So I made up my mind, I must go. So then I combined that with some other official programs also. Yesterday there was India's International Science Conference. That's an official program. And then we also had a couple of other programs also. And I combined this with that program. And I'm happy that I'm able to come here. Friends, now the country needs both business, industry and agriculture. Because our country is huge, agriculture is our basic culture. At the same time, business and industry also are required for the country's growth. It's like 2 eyes of a human being. If you have only 1 eye and focus only on agriculture, then you will be onti kannu, one-eyed person. Or if you have the other eye, industry, then you don't focus on agriculture, then you cannot have the full view. So these 2 things should be encouraged. And I feel sometimes some politicians, they curse, they condemn, they criticize the businessmen in daytime, at the same time do business with them in the night time. That's the practice of some politicians in this country. Because after all, businessmen are there to also to produce, to create wealth for the country. So nobody should have any hesitation in meeting, in greeting, in talking, in walking with the businessmen, because they are also doing a duty. So that way industry has to be encouraged, business has to be encouraged. If you want to really develop the country, without industrial development, without business development, your rupee cannot be strong. And you cannot be prosperous. And you cannot do social service without money. You need to create wealth to distribute wealth. Sampadana penchite panchavachu. Penchakunda panchite pancha matrame migulutundi ani cheptunne vaadu nenu intamundu. Ippudu cheppalante kodiga sankochinchala. Vice President. పంచు పంచగట్టుకునే వైస్ ప్రెసిడెంట్. కొంతమంది అడిగారు నన్ను, సార్ ఇంగ్లీష్ ఢిల్లీ జర్నలిస్ట్, సార్ నౌ యూ బికమ్ వైస్ ప్రెసిడెంట్, వాట్ అబౌట్ ద డ్రెస్? ఐ సెడ్ నో చేంజ్ ఆఫ్ డ్రెస్, ఓన్లీ చేంజ్ ఆఫ్ అడ్రస్. ఫ్రమ్ 30 అబ్దుల్ కలాం ఐ బి గోయింగ్ టు 6 మౌలానా ఆజాద్ రోడ్, దట్స్ ఆల్. ఐ విల్ నాట్ చేంజ్ మై డ్రెస్, ఐ విల్ నాట్ చేంజ్ హియర్. Not that I am in Chennai, I am wearing this. I will not change it in Andhra or Telangana, or not even in Delhi, or even when I go to abroad, World Bank or United Nations, there also I will maintain the same dress. Point is, you must always respect your culture, your heritage, your traditions, which was given by your forefathers. Depending on the time and the weather condition, one can change the dress for that particular situation. You should not be very rigid and say, no, 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 I don't wear any woolen, this thing, I don't wear, take anything, care. Then it will become problematic, and then you have to go to Apollo Pratap Reddy. So we have to take care, but same time, tradition has to be maintained. So friends, we have to create wealth. How do you do it? By encouraging industry, by removing the bottlenecks, and also giving certain incentives. I'm happy the country is moving in that direction. Initially, after independence, government used to do business, because at that time there is no money that much available in the private people. Banks also were not that much forthcoming to give money. That's why nothing wrong initially. Government of India getting into larger business, setting up industries, BHEL, BHPV, HAL, SCL, here and there. But by doing so, slowly government entered into other business also, constructing hotels, running hotels, and then incurring loss and going to the people, sir, we prepared biryani, we could not sell it, so we taxed the people. Producing cycles, is it the duty of government to produce cycles and motorcycles? And incur loss and then put tax on people. See, the government's duty is to create infrastructure, road, electricity, drinking water, drainage, food to the poor people, taking care of the suppressed, oppressed and depressed people. That is the government duty. But government, as I told you, fully got immersed into business and incurred heavy losses. So now they have realized that they are slowly coming out of business, because the principle, the government has no business to be in business. They have to focus on service to the people. Second point I want to tell you is that the country's policies should be such that you learn from experience of other countries. Accordingly, you modify your policies, your programs, and also decide what is best suited for India and what is the talent available among Indian people, how to encourage the talent and how to unearth the talent, how to unleash the force of growth. This is what Vajpayee ji has done. National highway, rural highway, then the teleconnectivity, air connectivity, rail connectivity. All connectivity revolution he brought, the growth started. Now, present government also believes in this philosophy. That's why the Prime Minister said, development, development, development is my agenda. After 69 years, 70 years, if you still have basic problems remain, then it's a challenge. There are challenges before us. Illiteracy is a challenge, 20% or so. Poverty is a challenge. 20 or 25% of the people do not have proper food, clothes and shelter. And then you also have social challenges, social inequalities. You also have urban-rural divide. Everything is full here, everything is dull there, if not nil. You have challenges like this. And then you also have challenges of some of the social evils. So we have to focus on that. And I'm happy the government, central government, state government, they're all focusing on that. I'm not into politics, so I don't want to speak politics. But the point is, the focus should be creation of wealth, increasing the GDP, and then distributing it among the poorer people. And then you go for inclusive inclusive growth. The growth has to be inclusive, only few people becoming big, rich, and then other people suffering without food. That's not a growth. The growth has to be inclusive. At the same time, to make poor people to grow, there's no need to bring down big people. It's like you want to construct a single bedroom apartment, so you bring down multi-storied building and make equal. That's not the proper approach. And any philosophy in that regard is wrong. It is proved to be wrong. You need to create competition. And you need to give a preferential treatment to the rural people, to the weaker sections, to the women, and others who have been deprived of such opportunities. That should be the policy direction of the country. I'm happy such things are happening now. And then we must also understand the aspirations are growing. We have the population which is aspirational. We have a young generation of 65% below the age of 35 years. It can be converted into a demographic dividend. And there is a talent among the people of various sections, in various regions. That talent has to be spotted and encouraged. And you need to go for skill development. That's why a lot of programs are coming. So these programs, friends, should be taken as national programs, people's programs. They should not be left as Narendra Modi's programs or Palani Swamiji's programs or some other party programs, if that party is in government in one state. They should be taken as national programs. Swachh Bharat, clean and green. What is party in that? Beti Bachao, Beti Padao. What is party in that? That means encourage the girl child. You know, if the girl's number becomes less and the boy's number becomes more, what will happen? Even otherwise, you are seeing what is the problem. And then tree plantation, what is politics about it? You need greenery. You need, there were some people said, if there are rains, trees will grow. Trees grow, if trees grow, then rain will come. One has to understand that. So that's the importance of tree plantation. You must also protect rivulets, the tanks, also preserve the rivers. Now rivers are drying up. There's no water in many of the rivers in the country. First time I'm happy, Mr. Jayakumar was telling me now all reservoirs are full in Tamil Nadu. Same is going to happen to Andhra Pradesh also and Telangana also and other parts of the country, I hope. Because rains are getting reduced because we have successfully cut all our forests and now we are going for tree plantation. I don't know how much time it will take, but we must. Then we must also go for reforms. The Prime Minister has given an advice or mantra, whatever you call it, as reform, perform and transform. You want to transform the system. You want to transform the nation. World is moving faster. You have LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. We are living in a global village. We must learn from others' experience. We are wise people. And then go for new practices, new encouragement. Earlier, people used to talk about red tape. Now the Prime Minister is talking about red carpet to the industry. Why? Industry is adding wealth to the country that way. And then you have now two path-breaking recent initiatives taken by the government. One is about the GST. It's a collective decision of all political parties across the country. I was there in Parliament at the time. I was Minister for Parliament Affairs for some time. Tried to mobilize the support. This way or that way, little later or beginning, every party said, we want GST. And GST has been approved upon. Any new legislation, there will be some problems. Any transformation, there will be some problems. And there are problems. How can anybody deny? And the debate is on. Let the debate go on. Nobody should worry about the criticism. But the criticism has to be meaningful and has to be purposeful, whether GST is really useful or not. Once having agreed for GST, now you can only think about implementation part of it. How to make it more effective, people-friendly. That is the idea. We are all seeing the debate. Sometimes the debate is on proper lines. Sometimes the debate is going off the road. And then we also had gone for the remonetization or demonetization, whatever it is, that also there is a debate going on. Let the debate also be healthy, nothing wrong. And you know, corruption was eating into the vitals of the system. I'm not referring to this party regime, that party regime. That's not my responsibility now. But it is a fact, corruption at various levels. You have to wage a war against corruption. You have to end black money. One idea was this. Whether there are other ideas, good ideas, Binami Transactions Act, and there are other good ideas, people can come forward, give those ideas, pressurize the government, and tell the people also, they have gone wrong, we will come to power, we will do like this. The debate has to be on those lines, rather than criticizing while in opposition, oppose, and government, while you are in government, propose, and you are in opposition, oppose. That's not a correct thing for a democracy. So friends, today, the entire country should think on those lines. And this, we have new problems of solid waste. Solid waste management is a problem, massive problem. We have a water problem, like water is going to be a major issue in the coming days. So you have to go for rainwater harvesting. You have to go for check dams. You have to go for preservation of the traditional ponds and rivulets. And then you have to go for regeneration of the rivers, and ultimately you have to go for river linking also, which will be useful, because konni chota karuvu, konni chota atavrishti, konni chota anavrishti, enta neellu samudramlo kelipothunayi manandaram chustunnam, vaatini neellu maliste dani valla enta upayogam untundo manandaram kuda ardham avutundi. Ilanti vaatini oka jatiya agenda ga teesukoni రాజకీయాలను పక్కన పెట్టి అందరూ కూడా ఈ యొక్క అభివృద్ధి కార్యక్రమంతో అభివృద్ధి అజెండాతో ముందుకు వెళ్లాల్సి ఉంది. వేస్ట్ టు ఎనర్జీ, న్యూ ఐడియాస్. వేస్ట్ టు కంపోస్ట్, న్యూ ఐడియా. నీమ్ కోటింగ్ ఆఫ్ యూరియా, న్యూ ఐడియా. యూరియా షార్టేజెస్ గాన్ విత్ దట్ వన్ సింగిల్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ బాక్స్ ఐడియా. అండ్ దెన్ యూ నీడ్ టు గో ఫర్ పబ్లిక్ ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్, less private transport. Delhi has got 1 crore 10 lakh vehicles. Life has become horrible. Always tension, no attention, pollution. Earlier as minister, I used to go by metro whenever I used to go to Delhi. And because in metro, no tension, only attention you can read. Now, of course, as a vice president, if I go, I don't know what is going to happen. I'm thinking of doing it one day or other. Even Chennai also metro. I remember the last meeting I had with Madam Amma Jayalalitha was the metro function. We want to see that the public transport, then cycling, then pedestrian paths, then the other modes of transport has to increase. I went to Berlin some time back. 13% of the Berlin population are going by bicycle. Not that they can't afford, for health reasons. We must also think on those lines. For that you need proper roads. Then you need to have parking facilities. We have a weakness of parking everywhere, saying that it's a free India. I can do whatever I want. How can you do it? How can I do it? There has to be regulation from Taj Hotel. If you go out and you want to go this side of Nungambakkam, and the other man also want to go this side of Nimmakavakam, both of you say, it's a free India. I have got a fundamental right. I will move in whatever direction I want. And both of you will meet there and finally meet there. So there has to be some regulation. Public transport has to be increased. Private transport has to be reduced. New methods, solar lighting now, LED bulbs now, 40% of the energy bill can be reduced. That's another new idea. This has nothing to do with this party or that party, because Narendra Modi has formed a solar alliance. It's not a political alliance like BJP forming alliance or Congress forming an alliance. It's an alliance for the betterment of the country. So then rainwater harvesting, as I told you, every drop of the water has to be preserved. All these new methods in agriculture, country has to move in that direction. And industrial leaders, business leaders should guide the people, because they have the resources, they have the knowledge, and they should drive the developmental path of the country. And differences, if any, they can be thrashed. Definitely, they can be discussed also. Nothing wrong in having differences in a democracy. That's very always useful if they are purposeful, and then the country should move towards inclusive growth and focus on taking care of the last man in the queue. I am not talking the last man sitting here in the meeting. That's the concept of Antyodaya, taking care of the last man in the line, uplifting the poor and the poor and poor. And now new way of a direct benefit transfer, transferring the money directly from the government account to individual account rather than going through middleman. I recall late Rajiv Gandhi, when he was Prime Minister, once he lamented, if I send 100 rupees from Delhi, by the time it reaches Kanchipuram, only 15 rupees reach, 85 rupees leakage out of the package. We have to take care of it. That's why the new idea of DBT, direct benefit transfer. That's why new idea, not Prime Minister is talking about JAM, Janadhana, Aadhaar and Mobile, directory. You put it there, then some people are criticizing Aadhaar also, I don't know. Aadhaar is very much required. It will eliminate middleman, it will eliminate corruption. We should really strengthen this. I'm happy more than 100 crore people have already enrolled. That's a forward movement for the help, the sake of the country. And then the scholarship, the pension, the compensation for the land or the crop insurance, everything should go into the old age pension, should go to the account directory without the need to go meet, greet, shake hand and do something in between hand. There should not be any necessary for that. It should go directly to the people. That is the need of the hour. And then now digital is happening. Everybody should support the digital movement. That has nothing to do with politics. It is for the betterment. World is moving towards that. Everywhere it's becoming online. Online. If you don't follow online, you'll be in line permanently. One has to understand that also. So things has to be online. Municipal approvals online. All these business permissions online. This is the way forward. And we have to move like that in our life in order to make a strong, stable, prosperous nation. That's what is expected to be done. Friends, I would like to focus on one more issue and conclude, because we are nearing the completion of the meeting time and approaching the eating time. I don't want to take much of your time. In any legislation of a transformative nature, there will be problems. There will be some challenges. It is for the people, the rulers, the administrators, the officers, the ministers to find out how smoothly you can transform. That's a challenge. I received one WhatsApp yesterday. I'll just read. I'll not make any comment. Reasons for lower GDP growth during the past quarter. Imagine that you are appointed as a principal, director of a college which is notorious for cheating and poor quality of education. Imaginary. You find that most students cheat during the examination in that college with the support of the teachers and do quite well in exams. The result of the college has been always more than 90% in the recent years. You are a person with the principles and hence you decided to totally eliminate cheating from the examination. You install CCTV cameras, you make strict action in the examination hall, and also take action against the students and the teachers who are found engaged in cheating or malpractice. The result is that cheating is totally stopped in the examination. However, the performance of your college dips drastically, and less than 50% students pass. This has been a bad performance in recent times. You now face a flock from all sides. Students are angry because they had failed due to your strictness. Teachers are angry because their track record got spoiled because of your strictness. Trustees of the college are angry because the result of the college has taken a beating under your charge. And that's what is happening in India right now. I have no comments to make. I have no comments to make on that. Friends, the foundations of our economy are strong in this country. And then, entire world, globe, economies slide down. Even the neighbor, powerful economy, China, also is going little negative. India is the only place in the entire world where investors are looking to invest. I was urban development minister till the other day. More than 35 ambassadors met me and told me, Mr. Naidu, we want to invest here in smart cities, we want to invest in metro, we want to invest in solid waste management, this, that and all. There are a lot of people who are queuing up. That shows there is confidence that India, you can invest. And then we have also seen the reports of the World Bank. The reports of the World Bank also are there, which is suggesting that the Indian economy is strong. And then by the efforts made by this thing, the country can definitely move forward because of the, I will just read two lines from World Bank and also from the International Monetary Fund. The World Bank report says, latest, the economic activity according to the country's snapshot published by the World Bank is expected to stabilize Indian economy, maintaining annual GDP growth rate at 7% in the year 2018. The report goes on to say growth is projected to increase 7 to 7.4% by fiscal year 2020, underpinned by a recovery in private investments prompted by a recent increase in public capex and improvement in the investment climate, partly due to the passage of the GST and the bankruptcy code and the measures to attract FDI. This is World Bank report. Describing the two major recent reforms in India, demonetization and goods and services tax, as a monumental effort, the International Monetary Fund chief said, it is hardly surprising that there is a little bit of short-term slowdown as a result. But for the medium term, we see a very solid track ahead for the Indian economy, she said to a question. So friends, this is the situation. Today you have the news that the wholesale price index has come down. Morgan Stanley says the economy regeneration has started. And also market cars, car sales, two-wheeler sales have picked up. Exports have increased by 23.67%. All these are all positive signs. And we must be always optimistic, should not be pessimistic. Political parties, they'll be quarreling, they will all be criticizing each other, let them do. But as for the people is concerned, and particular industry is concerned, be confident. We have a bright future, the country has a bright future. At the same time, friends, women empowerment is one of the key parameters for the progress of a nation or society. I'm happy that Andhra Chamber of Commerce, led by Mrs. Indira Dutt, has set up Women's Business Forum to impart training to women students and employees to enable them to become entrepreneurs. It's a laudable initiative. I hope the training is not confined to Chennai alone and will be conducted all over the state and other parts. The chamber must identify a few leading industries in each district and tie up with them for imparting training to women students and employees. I am told the forum also encourages women to take up community development. I feel that community development programs must not only help the local communities empower themselves, but also enable them to take up initiatives to reduce poverty, promote sanitation, hygienic practices, and create self-employment opportunities, among others. I have an opportunity to closely observe what my daughter and her friends and my friends are all doing together in Swarna Bharat. The initiatives for skill development, vocational training, is doing wonders. Thousands of women from the nearby villages are coming and they are getting trained. And children from Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Orissa are coming all the way to Nellore. That means there is an urge for skill development. And the government of India also have started a skill development initiative. State governments are also doing. We are happy about it. A study by the State Bank of India yesterday shown that villages who opened bank accounts under Janadhana Yojana, they are saving more and reducing their consumption of alcohol and tobacco. This is the report of the State Bank of India. So one has to be optimistic about all these developments and all, and not to be worried or carried away by the political discourse. Let it happen. As I told you, political discourse and debate is always useful. As long as the debate is purposeful, constructive, meaningful, nothing to worry. And parliament and legislatures are there to debate. If a debate takes place, I'll be the most happiest man. That's why I say discuss, debate and decide. Not do the fourth D. Fourth D is disrupt. Pranab Mukherjee, also the outgoing president, said discuss, debate, decide, not disrupt. That should be the way forward for all the legislatures also in the coming days. Friends, once again, I would like to compliment the Andhra Chamber of Commerce here in Chennai for doing an excellent work. And then moving forward, I hope in the coming days, the chamber will expand its activities further and also make all its members to go for corporate social responsibility as part of their life. That should be the habit, because Gandhiji has told us also, they are only trustees, and Manava Seva is Madhava Seva. That's what is required. I'm happy I could meet many of you today during my interaction with various sections of the people. Morning I was in MS Subbalakshmi's centenary celebration, where an exhibition is open. I suggest some of you who are all interested in music can really visit that exhibition in Lalit Kala Academy. Very beautiful, the long journey of MS Subbalakshmi. It has been depicted. And morning I went to another pious program, that is Takkar Bapa, that institution, which is a Gandhian institution, which is serving the cause of the poor and downtrodden. So like that, every one of you should get involved yourself in your own way, according to your might and your strength, your capacity. Because as I told you, the culture of India, the tradition of India is to take care of the society. And we have felicitated these people, Srinivas and Vanita Dhatra. The felicitation is to give inspiration to others. If they also work hard, they will also be felicitated. What is, they are not going to get anything by getting this shawl or this memento, but it will be a momentum, it will be a moment in their life to create momentum in the society, to give inspiration to others also to follow them. Thank you very much. Namaskaram. Andariki dhanyavadalu. Nandri. Vanakkam.